All right, guys, Infinite Warfare. For the people that have been saying, hey, Mark's been try IW, play IW, I've given it a little bit of, you know, a little bit of my time. I haven't completely ignored the game. I've just played what I prefer, and this is a game that I don't think I've preferred as much because I don't consider it to be as good. Ooh, shit. Okay. Well, I got one. What did he throw? What did that guy throw? What is that? He threw a fucking shooting star at me. Wow, you haven't seen the intro in a while. Welcome it back, man. Anyways, today I wanted to do a live video, but I couldn't handle it. I just keep coughing. I'm feeling much better. I just have a headache and a cough at this point, and the cough is relentless. So I coughed like 30 seconds straight before the video, and now I'm going to talk about the important shit now for 5 minutes and what has happened, because it's a big deal. GFK, which is a chart tracking site in UK, recently came out with some numbers that Infinite Warfare sales and overall player base has dropped, because obviously the player base is based off the sales, but has dropped by 48.4% from BO3 to Infinite Warfare. And BO3 had dropped from Advanced Warfare as well, thinking, oh, well, you know, maybe it was because they're tired of all this futuristic shit. Advanced Warfare was actually higher. So year after year, this futuristic ridiculousness of a game is getting punished in sales, and 48.4 is an enormous drop. Even with the sale of COD 4 with Infinite Warfare, it was almost 50% of the players were like, fuck this, we're not doing it again. And I'm proud of you guys that did that. I'm proud of you. I want to say that. I also want to mention that there are some other things that affect the sales, like the fact that it's not sold on the older consoles, but I'm proud that it has dropped that much. And, you know, I rely, honestly, I 100% rely on the game being popular for my success in my career. Because if no one wants to play the game, no one wants to watch the game. It's not like I can just go play Barbie Simulator 2014 and I'm going to get a lot of fucking viewers. Ain't going to happen. My career relies on a popular game. But that being said, I prefer COD 4 way more than Infinite Warfare. This game overall works. It's not bad. Functionality, it works. You can jump, you can move, you can shoot, you can play with people, you can invite them. You have their pay-to-win system of supply drops. Probably not as pay-to-win as it could be, but we'll see as the year goes on. It might get worse. Overall, though, it works, which is good. But the game isn't Call of Duty, and that's why people are leaving, I think. It's not like COD anymore. It's Halo, it's Titanfall. I liked Halo, too. I liked Halo as well, but it's not even Halo. It's like a cross between Call of Duty, Halo, and Titanfall, but it's not Call of Duty. And I think because of that, people are leaving and not playing it anymore. And I want to mention, just because they're trying to go futuristic does not mean they have to go as far as they have gone. You can go futuristic without making it flying, wall running, laser weapons, etc. I don't know why they chose to do that. That was their choice, but it has hurt them. And not only has it hurt them in their games and their feedback, it's hurt them in their sales, which is perfect. It's perfect. Because these companies aren't going to learn unless they lose money. Because that's all they fucking care about. Right? It's a company. I understand that. They have to make money to survive. But they don't care about their users. They very rarely do. I mean, it's noted that look at how many community managers these companies have. You couldn't name them. You couldn't name them because they don't fucking care. They don't respond to feedback from the community. They don't tell you why things are wrong. Their community managers don't exist because they get too much harassment, supposedly, from the community, which is technically true. So we should probably be a little bit nicer to those people. But it's just, it doesn't exist. The communication between the companies that develop these games and the players that play them is at an all-time low. It's essentially non-existent. I can tell you that I don't think I've ever had Vonderhaar respond to me on Twitter. Ever. I've tweeted him maybe 50 times. Sometimes it's a rage tweet. Sure, he should ignore those. Sometimes it's actual good feedback that lays out a lot of the problems that they should work on. And guess what? Never a response. Never thank you for letting us know. Never these are being worked on. Never that has been already solved. We're releasing a fix soon. Doesn't exist. And those were problems that functionally, it wasn't like an opinion, like High Caliber sucks, remove it. That wasn't that's an opinion. I don't like that caliber, but sure, let's get rid of it. But I was like, hey, the party system's broken. We should fix this so we can play in parties. Like, that kind of problem never responded to. So I'm proud of you guys that you have resisted the urge, for the people that have, to buy this game and give them money for fucking over the community over and over. I cannot be prouder. And it hurts me to say that. It hurts my business. It hurts my YouTube channel, whatever. It hurts everything I do. But I cannot be prouder. I will play Modern Warfare Remastered mainly. I will not play this game. I will not promote it. I will not push the sales of it. I will not push the supply drops of it. I will not buy supply drops on it. They can lose more and more money until they figure out that they should make a game that is similar to what they have been making in the past. They don't need to go futuristic for people to enjoy the game. I will use the example of Modern Warfare being popular, Modern Warfare 2 being popular, and Modern Warfare 3 being popular. All three games were huge successes, and none were fucking futuristic. They were all modern warfare. Black Ops was popular. Black Ops 2 was relatively futuristic, but not too much. It was still good. Black Ops 3 was way futuristic. It kind of turned some people off of the Black Ops series, but it was still decent. It was a little too much, but it was still decent. But because of the sale drop and because of the overall drop in players, I'm sure this year on YouTube will be pretty slow. Even if I do MWR, it's gonna suck, but that's the price I pay for playing this game. And I guess relying on developers like that. We'll play more games. Don't worry. I can always play other games. It's cool. But I'm proud of the people that didn't buy the game and support this company in their crusade to fuck us over. So thank you guys.